We have some strange cases that aren't often spoken about, and we have the classics. And I thought it was time we talked about one of the latter category. So I did some research on a creature that supposedly sucks blood. Didn't we do vampires just the other day? Oh, but wait, this one is about a goat sucker. He sucks goats. Well, at least the blood of goats. It's a goat vampire. Hey, who dreams these things up anyway? This is the series where I tell you a story, its subsequent theory and explanations, and then I let you make up your mind. This time we found out what the chupacabra actually is. It's a legendary creature in folklore of the Americas called the chupacabra. From the Spanish chupar, which means to suck, and cabra, meaning goat. It first attacked in 1995 in Puerto Rico, where 8 sheep were found dead, each drained of their blood, and investigators found strange puncture wounds in the chests of the animals. Told you, vampires. Many saw similarities to the enigmatic cattle mutilations, which had been taking place in the American Southwest. However, despite the odd circumstances, authorities attributed the killings to a known predator, like a fox for instance. Madeline Tolentino has the honor of being the first to have sighted the creature. Her eyewitness statements are the basis for most of the famous drawings of the chupacabra. I hope she ran like hell. About 30 citizens of Canovanas claimed to have seen the chupacabras, stating they swooped down from the sky and leapt over the treetops. On November 19, 1995, an eyewitness gave a detailed description of the chupacabras. On the same night, the creature struck again, as dozens of turkeys, rabbits, goats, cats, dogs, horses, and cows were found dead. No explanation available, except for the mysterious markings left by the blood-gorging chupacabras. This is a Blood Red episode. In Caguas, one was seen who tore apart a child's stuffed teddy bear, left a puddle of slime and a single piece of rancid meat on the windowsill. By the end of 1995, more than 1,000 mysterious animal deaths were attributed to the now infamous chupacabra, and it soon spread across Mexico and the American Southwest. Talk about illegal aliens, right? They have large oval red eyes, gray skin, a long snake-like tongue, fangs, and long spinal quills that may double as wings. The chupacabra stands between 1.2 and 1.5 meter or 4 to 5 feet tall, hops like a kangaroo and leaves a foul, sulfur-like stench. Three-toed tracks have been found and zoologists could not compare any known animal to this strange portrait. Doesn't even sound like from Earth, right? The Grunches from New Orleans are said to be similar to the chupacabra. The Quenches of Chile, although they're described as winged snakes. And the legendary Philippine Sigbin shares a lot of the chupacabra's characteristics. After a 5-year investigation, Benjamin Redford concluded that the description given by the original eyewitness in Puerto Rico, Madeline Tolentino, was based on the creature Syl in the science fiction horror film Species, as the creature is nearly identical to Tolentino's chupacabra, and she had seen the movie before her report. Therefore, the most important eyewitness report can be trusted and the chupacabra can be a real animal. 5 years of study, and this is what he comes up with. Most believe the bizarre creature is a product of the human imagination, a legend, folk superstitions. According to them, the cattle were slain by a gang as a bad joke, or that they were killed by a religious sect or even Satanist with occult intentions. Okay, it isn't enough we're being stalked by a monstrous freak, now demon worshippers and witches have to scare us too? Well, that's not the scariest bit, because some believe the chupacabra to be a demon vampire, or even the devil himself. Texas, July 2010, in Hood County. Animal control shot and killed an alleged chupacabra. After scientific tests, it was found to be a coyote-dog hybrid with mange and internal parasites. Mange is contagious skin disease caused by the parasitic mites that are mostly seen in domesticated animals. In addition, University of Michigan biologist Barry O'Connor concluded the chupacabra in the United States are simply coyotes infected with the parasite Sacoptes sacabiae. The disease caused by these parasites makes it look like, well, a chupacabra basically. In addition, they supposedly attack goats because they're in a very weak state and unable to hunt. So why don't the goats just step aside then, eh? Many think the attacks cannot be the work of dogs or coyotes because the victim is not eaten. Others say this conclusion is incorrect, as prey could have been left uneaten because they are inexperienced, or due to injury or difficulty in killing the prey. And allegedly, the reports of blood sucking by the chupacabra were never confirmed. Diseased animals. They're probably just as dangerous. Staying with the animal explanation. Could it be the chupacabra is genetically engineered, a monster? A lot of the genetic research is done on different life forms, but the result does not always turn out as expected. Believers of this theory say it is a failed experiment that escaped from a laboratory. So all these attacks are basically just done by one creature? And last but certainly not least, the one you've been waiting for. Is the chupacabra of alien origin? Was it an alien pet unintentionally left behind, like E.T.? Or a pain in the ass animal they wanted to get rid of? Or did they come here to cross their genetic material with humans in order to create a new life form? Why make it so ugly then? The possibilities are limitless in this one. And it adds a whole other dimension to my illegal alien joke of a few minutes ago. A classic case that ends with a classic explanation. Aliens! But whether or not the chupacabra even exists, and if so, what it is, you decide! If I forgot something, or you have something to add, don't hesitate to do so. If you wish to do your own research, the links in the description might be a good start. Your thoughts and opinions are much appreciated, so drop a line in the box below. Just be respectful in the comments, as there are real people with real feelings on the other side. If you enjoyed this vid, you can like and share and subscribe to my channel. And you may want to click the little bell to receive notifications. I have my Raphael Verdonk's World channel you might want to check out. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!